We're getting up close and personal with some trees today. And this is our super special guest, Jess Gersony. Jess and I are in the same organismic and evolutionary biology PhD program at Harvard University, and Jess studies plant physiology in the Holbrook Lab.
Plant physiology is the study of all the chemical and physical things that a plant does in its daily life, like photosynthesis and transporting water up through the leaves from the roots. I'm interested in tree physiology. A lot of the things about tree physiology you can study in the lab, but what I'm really passionate and interested about, you have to get into the forest to study it. And you have to see them in their natural environment with all their friends around them with changing environmental conditions.
And what better place to do that than here at Harvard Forest? The forest is 4,000 acres of woodland located in Petersham, Massachusetts. It was founded in 1907 to be used for long-term research projects and education. So you're doing your dissertation research here?
I am. The main motivating question of my research is how will trees respond to drought? As you know, the planet's climate is warming, and one result of this climate change is widespread drought. So it's really crucial that we understand how trees respond to drought, because they're super important players in a lot of ecosystem functioning. Like, they provide shelter and food for different critters, they produce the oxygen we breathe, and they also prevent erosion and many other important things. So the first thing we need for this research is a tool to measure how dry plants are, and this tool is called the pressure bomb.
We're going to show you the pressure bomb in a minute, but in order for you to understand how it works, we have to talk a little bit about how water moves through trees. Trees get their water from the soil. It enters through the roots, travels up the stem and through the leaves, bringing water and nutrients to the whole tree. Water exits the leaves through tiny openings in the leaf surface called stomata. They look like little mouths. Water travels through trees in an intricate system of pipes called xylem. Water molecules like to stick to each other and to the walls of the xylem, so we can think of the water in the tree as a continuous stream from root to leaf.
This process isn't a pushing process, it's actually a pulling process. The atmosphere is a lot drier than the inside of a leaf. Water likes to travel to where it's drier, so water exits the leaves into the atmosphere, pulling up all of its neighboring water molecules as it goes. In this way, water is pulled up the plant. If we describe pushing and pulling in terms of pressure, pushing is positive pressure and pulling is negative pressure. The drier it is outside, the more the water is being pulled out of the leaves and the greater the negative pressure experienced by the plant. This negative pressure is what the pressure bomb measures.
So let's use the pressure bomb to see how dry the trees are.
The pressure bomb is too big to bring to the top of the trees, so we have to bring the top of the trees to the pressure bomb. To do that, I want to introduce you to a really special friend of mine. This is Bucky the Bucket Truck.
Nice to meet you, Bucky.
He's going to help us get some oak leaves.
Let's science suit up. All right, so we've made it. I can't believe this. We've made it up to the canopy. It is so beautiful up here. But what's next for the science?
So now we got to get the perfect leaf. It's at the top of the canopy. The water has the furthest distance to travel, so it has the most negative pressure at the top of the tree. And we also want them to look really good, because if they look really good, that means that the insects haven't destroyed them and messed up their functioning too much. So we take our handy dandy Ziploc bag. We
Why
breathe into it. You want it to be super moist because the stomata are still open when you cut it off. Mm-hmm. So that means if they're in a dry environment, water is going to continue rushing out.
Yeah.
And so you'll get a false reading when you do your pressure bomb measurement. So now we find the perfect leaf.
Yes.
All right, I got one over here.
You got a beauty.
Put them in our little bag. We need a couple more.
Oh, does this guy look okay?
Oh my God, that's a perfect. Why don't you harvest it?
Oh my God, really? Wait, I have to use something. All right. And now we have our beautiful moist bag of harvested leaves. Now we go down.
All right, downwards.
First we go upwards.
Oh my,
this is insane.
All right, Molly, this is the pressure bomb.
Remember, it's gonna tell us how dry the tree is by measuring the negative pressure of the leaf we harvested. It has three parts: a compressed nitrogen gas tank, a chamber with a special lid, and a gauge that reads out how much pressure is in the chamber. So here's how it works. Water is being held inside of our leaf by the negative pressure the leaf was experiencing at the time we picked it from the tree. We put the leaf inside the pressure bomb chamber with the petiole sticking out of the lid, and then we turn the gas on. The gas then flows into the chamber and causes pressure to build. So the two pressures wind up competing. The negative pressure is still keeping the water inside of the leaf, but now the positive pressure is trying to push the water out of the leaf as well. First, the negative pressure is winning and the water stays inside the leaf until the positive pressure becomes equal in magnitude to the negative pressure inside the leaf. At that point, the water is able to leave the leaf and we can see it pop right out of the petiole. We watch the petiole as the pressure builds, and at the exact moment the water comes out, we write down the pressure readout from the gauge. Let's try it. So we take out our leaf, we take the petiole and we stick it through that baby little hole in the lid. Finagle it, we put it in, and now we look at it under the microscope. It's adorable. You can see all the xylem tubes, all the pipes, you can see them.
Oh my gosh, wait, what?
So we're gonna open a valve and it's gonna allow pressure, positive pressure, to come into the chamber. Oh my gosh, it's coming. And that's when you record your measurement. 263.
Minus 263 PSI is incredible. That's almost 10 times the magnitude of pressure in a car tire.
Are the trees always experiencing such negative pressure?
No, in fact, they fluctuate dramatically throughout the day. For my dissertation, we're measuring throughout the course of 24 hours to see how dynamic they really are. But yeah, during the day, like we saw, the leaves are experiencing rapid water loss through their stomata, and therefore they're experiencing these very high negative pressures.
But why are the stomata open if it's causing the plant to lose all this water?
So the reason that plants have stomata is to allow carbon dioxide to come into the plant for photosynthesis, which is the process by which plants use energy from the sun to convert carbon dioxide into usable sugars. But it's not all bad. This transport of water is necessary to keep the leaves from wilting and to bring all of the nutrients up from the soil into the canopy. So during the day, when the sun is out and plants can photosynthesize, the stomata need to be open to let the carbon dioxide in. But we can see that during the night, the negative pressures are much less severe. This is because the stomata close, because plants can't do photosynthesis when there is no sun, so the stomata can close to save water.
So the pressure bomb has told us that this tree is very dry during the day and not so dry at night. And it's really amazing to see that a healthy tree handles that much fluctuation every single day. But what would it be like for a tree experiencing a drought?
That's a really good question. We expect that the tree would experience much greater negative pressures, which can be really dangerous. Remember how trees have a continuous stream of water from the roots to the leaves? When a tree is too dry, something called cavitation can happen. The stream of water is pulled so hard that an air bubble enters the pipe of xylem, rendering it useless. It can no longer bring water up to the canopy. If it happens in enough pipes, it can kill the tree. Cavitation is one of the key reasons plants die during drought.
So Jess, how are you using the pressure bomb to study how trees respond to drought?
I'm really interested in how drought affects other aspects of tree functioning, specifically the transport of sugars from the leaves to the areas that need sugar, like the growing roots or the growing fruits. To understand this relationship, we need a really accurate understanding of both the negative pressure of the plant and the process of sugar transport. And once we get this relationship, we can better predict how sugar transport will respond to drought and have a better sense of how trees will respond to climate change.
Jess, thank you so much for having us at Harvard Forest and showing us your work and introducing me to Bucky.
It was my pleasure.
And I just want to say that I think it's really amazing the work you're doing to advance our understanding of the impact of climate change on our really important ecosystems.
Thank you.
Don't forget to subscribe to Science in Real Life. Links to the Harvard Forest website, the Holbrook Lab website, and their social media channels are in the description, and we'll see you next time. This episode was brought to you by the American Society of Plant Biologists.